I'm about to tell you the story of a woman warrior. You'll never meet someone as strong, brave, and full of life. This is Lois Drake, but to us, she's known as Mimi. She was diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease in 2013 and has been struggling with the symptoms since. Alzheimer's is a progressive disease that destroys memory and other important mental functions.
Before I was even born, Mimi had a long life. She was the fourth of five children born in St. Louis, Missouri to a milkman and a homemaker. When she was 6 years old, her father passed away due to heart complications. She began working at age 11, babysitting a family of 10 children. At 14, she began working at a movie theater and worked there all throughout high school. She met her husband in October of 1970. A week after their first date, he proposed, and they were married in December of that year in a courthouse. They moved to Clear Lake in 1971 and had two daughters, my aunt and my mom. Then, I was born in 1999.
Mimi suffered many broken bones and injuries leading up to her official diagnosis. She also suffered through breast cancer, but came out a survivor. Through all of her medical issues, she always managed to stay positive and have a great attitude. That's part of what makes her so special.
The first time I met Lois, I was at the hospital taking care of my mother-in-law. Everybody was getting together for Kevin's birthday party, and I couldn't go because I was not leaving my mother-in-law. So Lois told Jennifer, says, well, I'll come stay with Mamaw while you go to the birthday party. And so Lois walked into the hospital room, and that was the first time I ever met Lois. And I have never forgotten that, because that is the way Lois is. She is a very caring, giving person, and I love her.
So I was out of state when Mom first moved in here to Orchard Park. And I think I got home maybe her third day here. So the first thing I did that morning was come up and see her. And I had visions of her sitting in her room, like sad and wondering where she was and why she was here. And when I got here, they said, oh no, she's in the activities room. And so I went over to see her, and she was listening to a volunteer sing, and she saw me. And she said, oh, I didn't know you were coming today. And I said, yeah, I'm here. How do you think? And she said, it's nice here. I like it. And at that moment, I knew she was going to be okay and that we made the right decision in moving her here to Orchard Park.
This is Orchard Park, a place for people with Alzheimer's disease. Each resident gets their own bedroom and bathroom, along with access to television and other features. Not only that, but every day the residents gather to eat their meals, do brain-stimulating activities, and sometimes even go on field trips. They try their best to make it a comfortable, entertaining home for all of their guests. Mimi officially moved into Orchard Park in June of 2017, and has been thriving there ever since. She has so much fun with the other guests. Moving her there was the best decision we ever made for her.
There goes my baby. There goes my heart. They're gone forever.
My mom is one of the strongest people I know. Growing up, it was very important to her that my sister and I were baptized. And my dad didn't agree for us to be baptized, so she baptized us herself in the bathtub, both of us by herself with her Bible. And with that being said, then as we grew up, we went to church, and we went through all of the classes, and she made sure her baptism was recognized through the church, which she actually had to fight through that. It was really exciting growing up in the church, because we became leaders as youth leaders in the youth group, where we met a lot of people that became part of our family. So my dad actually ended up getting on board and Mom kind of adopted all of our friends, all of the youth leaders, the leaders of the adult leaders, and it was interesting that a lot of the adult leaders of our church were actually interns or new engineers at NASA. So they actually transferred here and had no family, so Mom would invite them for Thanksgiving dinner. So our Thanksgiving dinner was probably about 22 to 26 people long, and it was our four, family of four, with our entire family of friends and people from church. And I think that's what makes mealtime so important to my mom at Orchard Park, because her table there is a larger table. They put the tables together and her group sits together. And when we go there, she introduces me to everybody at the table. She can't remember their names, but they are all dear friends to her. And it is a wonderful time for her at mealtime. And it is, I think it brings back the memories of us growing up for our Sunday dinners where we had our friends come over. We were always so busy throughout the week, but we always made sure that we had our Sunday dinner as a family of four, and sometimes 10 and sometimes 12 when she'd invite our friends and family over. So I think Mom obviously has always been a very strong, passionate and caring person. And I don't know how many people actually call her Mimi that aren't her grandkids, and how many people actually call her Mom that aren't her actual children. But she's an amazing lady, and it was very important for my sister and I to make sure that she went someplace where she'd be cared for. And with her Alzheimer's and being in the memory care, starting in the reflections and memory care, this was definitely the place for her. And she's well cared for and she's happy, and that's what makes us happy.
I'm still here, but yet I'm gone. I don't play guitar or sing my songs. It never defined who I am. The man that loved you till the end. You're the last person I will love. You're the last face I will recall. And best of all, I'm not gonna miss you. Not gonna miss you.